time to walk. There's 10 minutes, back in the boot, off to Home Depot. Oh man, I'll let you know how it feels in a little bit. I'm off to the rec center. I can't resist. I said this 5 days ago. And I really do believe on Sunday, I wouldn't be surprised if the podiatrist on Wednesday tells me, get off the crutches and then get out of the boot in a week from now. Meaning like 10 days from when you're watching this. But
that's guys, right. Today, when you're watching this, Sunday is the Cleveland Marathon. I'm not in Cleveland. I'm in Denver, Colorado. But I did kind of predict, based on the trend line, that I would be essentially pain-free and... right now, walking for 10 minutes in a running shoe, walking, pain-free. Pain-free. So, this is exciting. I know that I made the right call not going to Cleveland. I'm glad, so glad, I did not go to Cleveland. It's hard, but this is ridiculously exciting. All right, lunch break.
Obviously, you are not gonna
filming this guy.
Hello.
Filming this guy.
Yeah. Hey, that's a good day when you get yogurt just given to you. Nobody feeds it. See ya.
He can't have this camera. Oh, it looks so good. Little board lunch. Boom.
I think maybe I'll move your chair down here.
Bada bing, bada boom. Okay, thank you. I am not exactly sure what I filmed today. I know I went to Home Depot, and then, anyway, it was a long day, getting a lot done here at the house, just all over the place. So, anyway, if the storyline of today's daily vlog did not make sense, I do apologize, but hey, now we're here in the studio, time to talk about some more running shoes. That's right, I ordered more running shoes, and yes, keyword is RWY. For Running Warehouse. Okay, I had a change of heart. You know, I remember I said this about 2 weeks ago. What is gonna be behind door number one? The New Balance Fresh Foam More. That is right, the New Balance Fresh Foam More. It's got a 4 millimeter drop, weighs 10.2 ounces, has a huge midsole, lots of EVA foam through that midsole. It's that patented Fresh Foam that New Balance has.
So I was pretty excited about the New Balance Fresh Foam More. But then, and this is where the YouTube family really comes in, and thank you. Basically, it was not one comment or two comments. It was at least, I would say at least 10 comments from all of you saying, whoa,
Be careful with the fresh foam more, because even though the midsole is pretty cushioned, it's still a harder landing. Anyway, the reviews from all of you, and then I went and did a little more research, were not good. And so I appreciate your feedback for the fresh foam more. I did not pull the trigger today on Running Warehouse. Instead, oh, and also I was looking at the 1080 V9 from New Balance, decided against that shoe as well, mostly because of the price. I felt like it was too high considering the shoe came out 6 months ago. And then also, why else? Oh yeah, I'm saving some money for the New Balance Beacon V2. That's right, it's supposedly July 1st, the second iteration of the New Balance Beacon will be releasing. So that is very exciting. So I thought, I'm not gonna buy the 1080 V9 today, and probably never, maybe the V10 down the road. And you might be wondering, wait a minute, Seth, why are you buying running shoes from Running Warehouse when you're always telling us to go support the local running shoe shops? Well, I look at this opportunity in the boot as a perfect moment to buy running shoes online, because if I went to the running shoe store, it's not like I'd be able to go jog around, if you know what I mean. So therefore, I decided to buy the first shoe from Running Warehouse, the Ultra Paradigm 4.5. That's right, a brand new iteration of the Paradigm lineup. It's a 30 millimeter stack height. I remember yesterday we talked about maximalist shoes versus minimalist shoes. Go check it out, upper right hand corner. So this is definitely, I would say, in the maximalist shoe category. High cushioned road shoe from Ultra. It does have a little bit of stability built into the shoe. And usually I'm all about neutral running shoes, but I do have a little bit of overpronation, and so I'm just interested to see what this shoe does for me. And okay, I should have mentioned this at the beginning. I'm gonna be using this shoe, the Ultra Paradigm 4.5, to replace the Ultra Torin 3.5. So this has been, as many of you know, my easy day shoe, bop it along shoe, along with the New Balance Beacon, basically. Why? I love the zero drop feel on when my volume of training gets above 70 miles a week, my legs start barking at me, and that is when I really start to look forward to running in a zero drop shoe to help stretch it. Why? To help stretch out my calf, my soleus, keep my Achilles tendon happy. And so anyway, I love Ultra for that purpose, and I've been running a lot of my easy day runs in the Torin, and so the Paradigm 4.5 will replace the Torin in the easy day lineup. So I cannot wait for this shoe to arrive. And again, 30 millimeter stack height, zero drop, pretty heavy, so over 10.5 ounces, so it's a heavy shoe, and I'm okay with that for a daily trainer. I'm not afraid of heavier shoes for daily training. And the second shoe, okay, I know many of you out there are not convinced that Skechers can create a running shoe, but I'm not giving up on Skechers. In fact, I think the Razor 3 really treated me well in the last 4 months. I'm just gonna say it. And the only problem with the Razor 3 for me was the upper felt like it was a little cheap. It wasn't made really, really well. But so the second shoe that I bought today from Running Warehouse is the Skechers Go Run 7 Hyper. Skechers Go Run 7 Hyper, a very lightweight, neutral daily trainer. We're talking 7 ounces. So this is on par with the it's lighter than the Nike Pegasus 35 Turbo and just a little heavier than the New Balance Beacon. And so I cannot wait. I'm excited. And again, I know Skechers is like, can they pull off a running shoe? I think the only issue with Skechers for me at this point is durability. I have found that my Razor 3 that I have is starting to wear out just after like 100 miles through the outsole. Some people would disagree with me on that, because I've seen pictures of other people's Razor 3 running shoes, and their outsoles after 250 miles are still holding up. So we will see. I'll keep you posted once these two shoes arrive, the Ultra Paradigm 4.5 and the Skechers Go Run 7 Hyper. Cannot wait. And yes, I did have a change of heart. I haven't forgotten about the Brooks Cascadia 14, and then also, yeah, the Ultra Vanish XC cross country spike for kind of an up-tempo grass training shoe for some 1K repeats on grass at some point down the road. And there you have it. That is today's daily running vlog. And yes, my next walking session will be on Monday. So stay tuned for that. There's light at the end of that tunnel. No matter how dark your injury tunnel might be, there's always light. Just like it's out there, but you gotta keep treading forward ever so patiently and slowly. Okay, question of the day. What was the last piece of running gear that you ordered online? So not from a running shoe store, but online. Any piece of running gear, doesn't have to be a running shoe. Can you go back and remember what it was? I'll be curious to hear, because guess what? It's summer training season. That means you might be needing to buy some new hydration bottles or a new hat, new sunglasses. Who knows what you're buying these days, but let us know down in the comments. I'd appreciate it. Thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. Thanks for the support. It's inspiring and, man, getting exciting. It's getting exciting. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. Woo! RW. See you tomorrow.